So you know the school water? Why it like that? I'll leave you alone forever now. Do you know a girl with hair like this?
Flowers. She just moved here. Got a job at Kings Island.
Scott, are you waiting for the schedule change you just ordered?
Maybe. I was thinking about walking you to your next class, but then I realized how stupid that would be.
Okay.
You want to go out sometime?
If I say yes, will you sign your scheduling ticket?
So what are you doing right now? Hey, would you be interested in going to this Battle of the Bands thing?
You have a band?
Yeah, we're terrible.
Mr. Pilgrim!
I am the first aide in Ramona's study hall bell.
Wait, we're fighting over Ramona?
Did you not get the Google Classroom notification explaining the whole thing?
Nobody reads those!
If we're gonna continue the date, I need you to aid for my 7 study halls.
Does that mean we're dating?
I guess.
Does that mean we can sit next to each other and stare at our phones silently?
What are you doing? What did you just do?
What are you talking about?
Why'd you just, like, do all that?
What do you mean?
Why'd you... Okay, it's fine. We don't have time for this. We literally have diddly squat.
It'll be
fine. We have nothing written. There's nothing ready for this episode.
Everything's gonna be fine. I'm literally, like, the star of Team TV.
But nothing's written for
star of Team TV. And as long as I'm in the skit, everything will be fine.
But we don't have anything written. Like, nothing's ready for this episode. Nothing is ready. We haven't filmed anything.
It'll all be fine. Oh my god. Stop worrying so much.
Okay. Roll the next clip.
Skip class?
I heard skipping class was bad. And we can get a Saturday school if we get caught.
Trust me, we won't get caught.
Skipping to class is harmful and dangerous. There are risks that the average student may not think of. You can slip and fall.
Youch!
You could hit your head.
Jeepers!
If the hallway is crowded, you could cause more of a traffic jam if you're skipping.
Thank you for these helpful tips.
We'll never skip class again.
Juliet and Mira went on to skip school 149 times. Each.
Lily?
What do you want?
We have to film. Since you didn't charge the cameras last night, we don't have anything
filmed. I literally was doing goat Pilates last night.
But I asked you to charge them so that we could film the skits today.
You're like a producer, right? Can you produce me a Fiji water, please?
No, I cannot, because we have to get this episode done.
It's not that big of a deal. You really need to stop worrying.
Okay, let's just get started, okay? So for today's episode of Team TV...
Oh my god, are you guys fans?
Lily.
Yeah?
Come on. We have to film.
No, we don't. Not yet.
Lily?
You guys
is there something
so
for
sweet.
The next clip?
Roll the next clip.
Being in the middle of the game just takes away everything in my mind. All I'm focused on right there is the game, and the adrenaline rush we get is insane. It makes us feel like we can do anything in the world. Lacrosse has taught me how to be a part of a team, definitely taught me like motivation, like how to stay focused, and just trying to lead our team to one goal, which is winning.
The best part of lacrosse for me, making new friends, definitely. Getting to know them throughout practices and games and seeing how they are on and off the field just really helps grow friendships.
In the middle of the game, it's so exciting just to like have the crowd going, have your teammates cheering for you. Especially when it's a close game, it just gets super intense and it's just a great feeling.
I got involved in, I think it was sixth grade. I was playing baseball at the time and my buddy was like, hey, you should come and try lacrosse one year. So actually sixth grade, I played baseball and lacrosse at the same time and got fallen in love with lacrosse and stuck with it.
One of the main aspects lacrosse has helped me with is definitely leadership, being a leader and a captain. It teaches you leadership skills. So we practice 5 days a week, Monday through Friday.
Lacrosse inspires me in life because not only does it help with leadership and all that, but it also helps with communication. Leading a team, you definitely have to have good communicational skills, which will definitely help later on in life with jobs, businesses, family, and all that. So if any of you guys are interested in lacrosse, you could definitely reach out to me or Sam. Hudson Newman, you could reach out with him. He's a big lacrosse guy. And you could also email our coach, Ryan Chamberlain, too.
Hello? Dr. Weirdo? Dr. Natural? Dr. Strange?
Oh, hello.
Hey.
How can I help you?
So I kind of failed this really important test. I don't know how, but it ruined any college opportunity I have. Is there any way you could help with that?
Well, there is a way, but it's kind of direct.
I'm down for anything.
Well, okay. Nice knowing your smarts, kid. The entire school's about to forget your intelligence. Including me.
Wait, everyone? Can't some people still know?
That's probably not how the spell works. It's definitely pretty dangerous to try to change it mid-casting.
Wait, so my friends are gonna forget about all the studying we did? Are they even gonna be my friends anymore?
I don't know. Are they your friends just because you're smart?
I mean, I hope not.
Did they always sit behind you during tests?
Yeah.
All right, fine. The entire school's about to forget about your intelligence, except your friends.
Thank you. Wait, what about my teachers, my administrators? Don't they need to know?
Okay, fair. Let's not change the parameters of the spell anymore.
What about my mom? What about my dad?
Stop tampering with the spell.
But what about my study buddies? What about the mailman? What about my grandma?
Kid.
What about Lionel Richie?
Will.
What about my uncle?
You stop.
What about my dog?
Talking.
I done got all
I'm
ass.
Passing with. All D and one C.
Did it work?
Yeah. Nobody remembers that you were smart.
Yes, thank you.
Wrestling has inspired me to really go for my goals. It's just all season you're just working to achieve those. It kind of just teaches you to never give up and keep trying. So we practice every day after school from about 2:40 to 5. And then we normally have competitions on Wednesdays, and most weekends we have a tournament. If you want to get involved, you can contact Hensley, or just head down to the weight room and talk to him.
Wrestling has taught me to be a good teammate. It also kind of helps you in the outside world, like teaches you not to give up. Because if you wouldn't give up in a match, why would you give up on this? Like, just go for it.
My favorite part about wrestling is getting to be of such a good team. Everyone just treats each other like family, and going to competitions and everyone just cheering for each other and having fun, it's just awesome. Something you should know about wrestling is you shouldn't be scared to join. Like, you literally don't need to know anything about the sport, but you can just come on in and the coaches will teach you everything.
Lily, it's time for you to read your lines and film the host segment.
Do I have to?
Yes, it's all written right here. Everything's here.
Fine.
It's just a couple seconds, please.
Oh, that's so easy. I got this. Okay. Acting is hard on the hair, and I'd like to introduce you guys to Hair by Lily. It is my brand new hair.
Lily, come on. It's time to read the skit that I wrote.
I don't even understand these jokes. Can you make them easier to understand?
Well, we do have something.
Roll the next clip.
Textbook? I got a textbook case of senioritis. They say the pen is mightier than the sword. They didn't say anything about a sludge-o-matic. Chromebook? More like, I want to go home.
We have the students that are capable of everything. Hi, my name is Jennifer Coleman, and I am a career experience teacher here at Lebanon High School. I have a family consumer science degree, but I teach here. I teach an exploring careers class and a career experience class. So the career experience program is a program where kids get to taste test a little bit of everything. So they may come in with a career that they are already thinking of, and this could affirm that, yes, this is the career I want. Or it could be something where they have no idea what they want to do. We take them on a tour of something and they find something that matches what they want. And we really express to our kids, it's your personality. It's your styles of everything you do. It's who you are and how you can match with what something you want to do and you want to enjoy for the rest of your life. So it's not just something of a test score. It's really how you are going to feel about the job and getting out there and experiencing it.
What drove me to take this class was I needed to really decide whether or not teaching was what I wanted to do or not. And with this class, you will figure out what you want to do. So they put you out in that field and you get to decide.
So we believe that our high school kids really need to get out and experience the world. So our career experience kids leave in the afternoon. They go on tours of businesses. They shadow businesses. They have different experiences. And we call it an experience because everybody's experience is different. It could be shadowing one time. It could be actually working at a business for 2 weeks, 3 weeks, 4 weeks. It could be any kind of different opportunity for them to just interview people or speak with other businesses to find out what that career is really about.
The class is awesome. I mean, you basically get to go out and go see jobs and like go see whatever you want. Get to do things you want to do after high school, which is very cool. I think the class is just, it's super fun. The teachers are nice. Miss Coleman and Miss Brooks are awesome. They love to teach the class, so yeah.
I took this class because I know I wanted to do something in healthcare, but I didn't know exactly what. So I got to see all sorts of things like the lab. I got to see nursing, x-rays, and kind of see the different sides of healthcare. But I got to choose which one I liked the best out of all those. And that really helped me make a decision on what I liked.
So we have a variety of students in our career experience program. We have all students from intervention to AP. We have a lot of kids that are band or choir or singers or have something that they've done here at the high school that doesn't allow them to go to the career center. So we're trying to bring some of the career center stuff into a traditional high school. So we bring a lot of trades in. We have a lot of experiences with police and fire and some of the things that we offer at the career center. So then they have an extra opportunity to do something they really want before they decide on their career path for college or their training.
This class is 110% worth taking. I think, honestly, everybody should take it if you have the opportunity. You learn so many professional skills and it really puts you out there in the best way possible.
I'm Gustavo Bongiorno.
And I'm Lottie Price.
And this is Say Yes to the Prom Dress.
Hi, I'm Henrietta May. I am 17 years old and I live in the middle of a cornfield and I have never seen a job before. If I can't find a prom dress today, I think I'm just gonna ask my daddy to buy the Great Wolf Lodge so I can go to prom in my PJs.
So who do you have in your entourage here today?
Well, I brought some of my closest folks to help me out. First, Emma, my best friend, she's my ride or die. I'm like excited to support her at all, but like if she even tries to choose the same color dress as me, I think I'll burn it. Then, Philip, my date, I am so excited to share this experience with him. I know it will be so special for us.
Man, I really don't care what dress she picks. I had to miss a car show to come to this, okay? I just wanna go to after prom.
And then my mama, she will be my biggest critic, but I need that kind of honesty in my life when picking out the perfect dress.
I'm surprised she even has a prom date. Heck, I'm surprised she even pulled herself together enough to buy a ticket.
Dress one is a cotton frock from the 1920s Susan B. Anthony collection. Let's see what the family thinks.
My granny would love this.
My granddaughter wore a similar dress. Oh, she's so cute.
Thank you. So, what do you guys think?
I don't know. I just don't really like how you look in it.
Really?
Yeah, like, it just looks like my junior prom dress. You need to take that one off.
Well, nobody thought you looked that good.
Well, I guess this is the dress to beat then.
I don't really care for the dress. I'm just here because I got the credit card.
What is your gut telling you?
I just want them to see who I really am through this dress.
Do you trust us to help you find your perfect dress?
Yes.
Dress number one was a dust bowl to her family and friends. Let's see if dress number two will be the cream of their crop.
Henrietta May, how do you feel?
I have never felt better in my entire life, and that is saying something.
And Mom, you?
My little girl looks like a pumpkin freshly carved on Halloween. She's so darling and cutesy. She's like a little peach from Georgia.
Well, it looks like I have an important question to ask you, Henrietta May. Do you say yes to the prom dress?
I do.
Okay, everyone.
Thank you guys so much for watching today.
Wait, I'm sorry. Can you?
What are you doing? My phone is ringing. What are you doing?
Hello? You need me for Dune 3? I'm playing the sandworm that eats Timothy Chalamet? Oh my god! Okay, I'm on my way.
Well, I hope you guys enjoyed this episode. I wanna go be a sandworm.